Back on the Eagles Sports Network, I'm Adam Cavalier alongside Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. Eagles fall to Lenoir-Rhyne today, 37-3. Ken, we were talking about it during the break, held under 100 yards of total rushing today, pardon me, for the first time in your memory. What did Lenoir-Rhyne do that was so effective defensively against you, and how much of it was on Carson-Newman?
Well, it's on me, and that's what it's on, because you know, we got a great group of kids, and we got kids that are playing as hard as I think many of them think they can, and you know, we had a pretty good game plan, I thought, coming in, but evidently not. And I thought we were pretty geared up to play this ball game, but evidently not. And that's all my fault. You know, that's on me. And so that was a dominated game. It's been a long, long time since I remember us being dominated as much as we were dominated today. And that's very, very disappointing. And again, it's on me. Got to really do some checking to see how I'm messing up here, and do it a little bit better, hopefully, the next time. And, we had started off pretty good with a good drive, and I guess maybe on our second series, and went down and then only got 3 points out of it. So most of our total yardage happened in the first couple, three possessions. Mm-hmm. And after that, it was pretty ugly. And defense at times really played hard, but the old curse of third down got us again. You know, we'd have it third and 7 or 8 or 9, and then somehow another would let them make the first down. But they played very hard, and they deserved to win this ball game. Lenoir-Rhyne did a great job, and you have to give them credit for whipping us pretty good. So, and again, I hate that I didn't have us better prepared to play.
You look at this defeat, and you brought up, when was the last time you can compare a game like this? Is 52-10 and 2010 comparable to it, or do you have to find another opponent, go back further?
Well, who we play next week dominated us pretty good last year. Newberry whipped us pretty good over there last year, and I hope that we got some heart that we can bounce back and play like we're supposed to, and I think we do. And so, I remember that was a pretty frustrating game last year. I thought we got dominated pretty good there last year. So you know, it's the difference was that one happened early last year. This was the 8th ball game, which is a little bit frustrating too. So, but we'll see what we're made out of now. You know, times like this make you better people, or you'll revert to doubts and pouts and shortcuts and excuses, and you won't learn or grow from it. And again, I have tremendous confidence in these kids, and I think we'll respond the right way.
You've touched on it in years past, avoiding losing to the same team twice. How do you prevent that from happening against a Newberry team? Again, second consecutive game against a nationally ranked opponent next week.
Well, it's a choice. It's a choice to depend on how we want to respond, and we'll see. A football team probably bigger, more physical than the team we saw this week. I don't know if they'll be as quick or run through us like this group did, but you'll see some unbelievable talent next week on the field against us. And we just got a choice about how we want to respond to it. Coach Barks has got to make a choice about to put these kids in a better position to win.
All right, Ken, we'll talk to you on Monday on the Ken Sparks Show.
Thank you.
That's Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. We continue with our coverage of Carson-Newman's 37-3 defeat to Lenoir-Rhyne. The Bo Jay's postgame report continues after this on the Eagle Sports Network.